death sentence. Kyshenko is going to go hard, going to go strong, and so too will Van Roosmalen. You are going to see a lot of action from the opening bell. There shouldn't be a filling up process in this one. The final! Michael Schiavello, Frank Trigg with you. And already those beautiful left round kicks off Kyshenko. Double jab, right hand from Van Roosmalen. High knee! And a high left round from Kyshenko. He's opened up like a house of fire. Inside leg kick from Van Roosmalen. Kyshenko, as I said, the favourite, minus 225. Van Roosmalen, plus 105. Nice jab off southpaw stance from Kyshenko. All tied up, nowhere to go. Referee separates. Kyshenko probing. He was fighting orthodox earlier in the night. He's southpaw here in the final. Is he hiding something? Is he protecting something? Or is he just trying to confound Van Roosmalen? Van Roosmalen on the inside. Catches him on the schnoggin. He'll be breathing out of the back of his head after that one, Kyshenko. Outside leg kick from Van Roosmalen. Kyshenko dips the liver. And again, attacking the organ.
Kyshenko's guard has opened up quite a bit from the last fight. And Van Roosmalen's finding a way to get inside every single time he wants to throw that straight right hand down the center. He's getting his way in there.
Kyshenko, the busy with the two so far. Sitting behind the jab. Throws the left down the corridor. It's an aggressive start for Kyshenko. Van Roosmalen forced to cover up at the moment. He's got to choose his time to go on the inside. Now he gets there. And Kyshenko puts him at range with the jab. Body shot. High knee! Tie clinch and knee. Nicely done from Kyshenko. Threads the jab again. The Ukrainian working his hands well. Van Roosmalen covers up, not letting anything get through the forearm. Backs Kyshenko against the rope, but the Ukrainian springs off back to center ring. Body shot, uppercut, right hook, outside thigh kick. Kyshenko putting down the points. Van Roosmalen goes to the body. The double forearms guard of Van Roosmalen is exquisite. The left hook.
No, he drops him! Let me come off! It's the shot! It's the shot!
Undersized, completely supposed to be overmatched in this fight, was not supposed to have the height, the reach. All he had was the power to get in there, and he completely sneaks all the way inside and gets in and knocks out Kyshenko. That was a huge victory. What a great shot.
He's only ever been knocked out twice before in his career, Kyshenko. Last time was back in 2010 in the third round. Before that, in 2007, in the second round, he has never been knocked out in the first round. What was that, 47 seconds? Incredible. Van Roosmalen, the underdog of the tournament, out of nowhere. The replacement for Giorgio Petrosian. He's gone through to win.
What a great job. That's amazing. Amazing to be able to pull us off. He peaked at the right time. He obviously had his technique down, stayed with the game plan. His coaches put him together perfectly.
Look at that left hand again behind the ear. Perfectly timed. One strike.
And the thing about it is that it wasn't the only strike he was trying to throw. He threw a three-punch combination, but only one punch landed before he fell down. That was the beginning of the three-punch combination. That's why you got to throw in combos. That's why you have to punch in bunches. Because you never know which one's going to be the one that's going to land and knock the guy down.
It was like when Ali knocked out Foreman in Zaire. Punch got him, then he threw a couple after that and just let him fall to the ground.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Man, that's amazing. What a great shot. Right in the temple.
Look at this.
Left hand right over the top.
Wow. I can't believe it, Frank. I mean, if you ask me who was going to win this tournament at the start of the night, I mean, Sauer, Kyshenko, the favorites, and Kimby on the other side of the draw, Van Roosmalen would not even have figured at all.
50 kilograms max. The winner by a knockout in the first round.
In the quarterfinal, he broke the tooth of Chahid Ulad Al-Haj in the second round. In the semifinals, he took out the world's champion at this weight, Chris Nagimbi, by decision. And here in the final, in the first round, in under a minute, he's knocked out Artur Kyshenko with a left hook of the highest order. Robin van Roosmalen, your champion. And Tyrone Spong there congratulating him. What a moment for van Roosmalen. What a moment for his camp. What a moment for his father, William van Roosmalen, who we said earlier had knocked out Vitali Klitschko back in the day when Klitschko was kickboxing. And now his son has just knocked out Artur Kyshenko.
$68,000.
For Mr. Kyshenko.
And he's not a big middleweight either. 5'7", 150 pounds.
And winner of the check of 20,000 euros. The number two of the Fast and Furious 8-man tournament, 70 kilograms max, Artur Kyshenko.
Kyshenko just seems to have bad luck when it comes to 8-man tournaments, Frank. He just can't seem to go that little extra and clinch one of them.
It's such a tough format to be in, really, to get through and be able to have the game, you know, have the fortitude to last through three fights of the night. It's so difficult. And then, really, a lot of it, too, is a little bit of luck of the draw. You know, a little bit has, you know, who do you draw in the first and second rounds? How do the fights go? And then what's going to happen with the opponent across the other way?
I mean, you cannot deny the fact that Kyshenko, probably out of everyone tonight, did look the best. He was incredible to watch all night. He brought the aggression. He brought the power. He brought the technique. He kept coming forward. But he made just one cardinal mistake of dropping his hand, and it took just a split second for Robin van Roosmalen to capitalize. That's the game of kickboxing.
Yeah, I mean, that's the way it goes in all athletic competition. Really, in team sports, you've got a shot to cover up a hole. Every now and again, you know, a guy may break away, but you can cover up the other guys on the field. In contact sports like this, whether it's kickboxing or mixed martial arts, one small mistake ends the whole night. Look at this guy. Robin van Roosmalen is definitely stepped up. And I'm so surprised, because I agree with you. Like, he was not on the radar at all. Just as a replacement came in and just kind of the guy's going to be there. And he shows up and wins the whole thing.
Robin van Roosmalen, if you didn't know his name before tonight, he's just become a household name in kickboxing overnight. Simon Roots presenting a final present.
Is it a watch? I'd wear that.
It's a $12,000 watch right there. Add that to the 68 grand US just won. He's having a very good night at the office.
Not bad.
The trophy.
Once again, folks, just to illustrate, van Roosmalen came in overall to win the tournament at odds of plus 800. In the final, he was plus 185. Kyshenko was minus 225. Out of nowhere, a real Cinderella story. You could say almost the equivalent to Mark Hunt winning the K1 World Grand Prix in 2001, when he was just there to make up the numbers, and he rampaged through the tournament, beating Jerome Labana and then beating Stefan.